वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसम प्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषजे भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। नत्वा श्रीभारतीतीर्थ विद्यारण्यमुनीश्वरो
नत्वा श्रीभारतीतीर्थ विद्यारण्यमुनीश्वरो
अधीमहे पञ्चदशी कैवल्यपदसिद्धये तत्त्वविवेक प्रकरणस्य द्वादश श्लोकः। यू कैन रिपीट द श्लोक श्लोक नंबर 12 फर्स्ट प्रकरणम् तत्व विवेक प्रकरणम् अध्येतृवर्ग मध्यस्थ पुत्राध्ययन शब्दवत् भानेऽपि भानं भानस्य प्रतिबन्धेन युज्यते। प्रतिबन्धोऽस्ति भातीति व्यवहारार्हवस्तुनि तन्निरस्य विरुद्धस्य तस्योत्पादनमुच्यते तस्य हेतुः समानाभिहारः पुत्रध्वनिश्रुतौ व्यामोहैक निबन्धनम् संबित एका न विद्यते सा संबित सत रूप सत चित रूपा संबित स्वयं प्रका स्वयं प्रभा संबित तस्याः संबित संबित श्रेणी का संबित मीन्स आत्मा तो सत अंचित सत अंचित लक्षणम been talked about in the beginning. Then what about Ananda? It is Banamba Banamba. Bane api avanam eva iti. The author said, why? If it is Banam, if Sambhita is Ananda Swarupa Sambhita iti Banam, iti Banam chet, then there will not be Vishayas Purha. If it is Abhanam, that you cannot say, because the object or the source of Ananda, Paranandaha, Paranandaha Atma Eva, Satparastu Kamaya Sarvam Priyam Bhavati, therefore, you cannot say it is not known. At the same time, you cannot say it is known. So therefore, there is not clear understanding about the Ananda Swarupa of the Atma or Atma itself. Satya Chitta, that by Yukti we established, then the regarding the Ananda, Swarupa, that Vanam or Avanam, why it is not able to be ascertained? Because of Pratibandha. Then the author gave the example, like the son of the Devadatta chanting, the Patashala is also chanting. He can see his the lip movement, but distinctly could not hear the chanting of the sun. Why? Because of the chorus chanting. Similarly, here also, so that is similarly here also in the case of Atma also, there is a chorus. What is a chorus? These anatma vishayas are the chorus chanting. So we are taken away by the chanting of this anatma, not able to hear the, not able to recognize this atma, Ananda Swarupa Atma. That is a pratibandha. Pratibandha also you defined. What is pratibandha? Astibhati iti vivaharaarha vastuni tannirasya tad virdasya upa. Tasya upadanam uchyate iti. What is pratibandha? Pratibandha means obstacle. Astibhati. In the astibhati, the swarupam of atma, that is nirasya tadvirdasya. Opposite to that which is produced. The swarupam of atma, Astibhati, that is what is everything is Brahma, Asti, Bhati. But when your interaction with the Vivahara, the Vastu, the objects of the world, you don't recognize that Brahma, Asti, Bhati. Without Brahma, how can there be Astitvam? Or there Bhati, Bhatitvam? Not possible. So Asti. Brahma is always Asti and it's always Bhati. That is not recognized. An object you see, because the Brahma is Brahma Bhati. The object is nothing but it doesn't have substance. Object as such doesn't have substance. It is nothing but a collection of attributes. An object is nothing but a collection of attributes which your sense organs perceive. So what you really perceive in the world is nothing but the attributes, the properties, with regard to anything or anybody also. What you perceive in the world is nothing but this attributes, these five attributes, Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. That is what your indriyas can perceive. And that is with what you have interaction. You cannot really interact with the person. You cannot really have the perception of the object. The vastu. Vastu means any object, anything. You cannot know it. It is not available for objectification. So what is available for objectification is only these attributes, the properties, which alone these indriyas can objectify. And therefore you think they are this. When you ask what is a rose, how do you define? A rose is a flower. It is available for your vision, for your perception, for sight perception. You see the color, it is rose. It smells fragrant. It is soft, available for your tugindriya, smell, granendriya. All these are available for your indriya vishaya. But what a rose is, that you really cannot know. That rose is nothing but Brahma, asti, Brahma asti, Brahma bhati, vyavahararga vastuni, asti bhati, tannirasya. Tannirasya. Viruddhasya tasya utpadanam. This astibhati nirakritya, dismissing that, opposite to that, what? That asti and bhati, it is considered as though belonging to the rose, as though you consider rose to be a substance, a thing, which really doesn't exist. It is mithya, which really doesn't exist. But you think that exist. So pratibandha is viruddhasya utpadanam. Viruddhasya utpadanam pratibandha. Tan nirasya astibhati vyavahara argam tam niradatni nirutve tan tat nirasya viruddhasya utpadanam. You don't recognize the astibhati. You don't recognize Brahma. That is covered by the object. Tannirakritya, viruddhasya, opposite to that. That is called pratibandha. Similarly, this drishtanta is a beautiful drishtanta. The sun chanting, not able to recognize. Similarly, the atma is always there, but not able to recognize. Because it is nicely covered by the namarupa. As in the chorus chanting, this Bhagubhigi Saha Patanam becomes the Pratibandha. Similarly here, the Namarupa covers this Brahma, which is of the nature of Asti, Bhati. That is covered. Tannirasya Viruddhasya Tat Utpadanam. Therefore, you take the Mithya thing to be, Mithya Vastu to be the real. Therefore, only Vyavahara. If you see the objects as Brahma, where there is Vyavahara, where there is Kartrutvam, where there is Bhoktutvam, there cannot be. When you see everything as Brahma, then Brahma Arpanam Brahma Havi, Brahma Agnav Brahma Nahutam, Brahma Iva Tena Gantavyam Brahma Karma Samadhina, Aham Na Karta Aham Na Bhokta, Agam na pramata, agam na ganta, agam na shrota, agam na drashta, agam shuddha brahma, shuddha chaitanyam. Then, agam, how can this agam, which is asti, asmi, अहम अहम इति ब्रह्म अहम अस्मि इट इज भामी आनंदोहम हाउ कैन इट हैव इंटरैक्शन व्यवहार व्यवहार विल बी देयर बट देयर विल नॉट बी कर्तृत्वम therefore there is no bandhakatvam for the jiva so that is pratibandha tasya yetuhu samana abhiharah this is what bhagavadgita sakapat patanam putrasya dvanihi not able to the sound of the sun not able to listen why because there is a chorus many people are chanting so distinctly the voice of the sun as it is not able to hear similarly atma is not available for your recognition distinctly why this covered by this nama rupa this mithya and you are carried over by this mithya jagat so therefore what is the cause what is the pratibandha vidya that is a pratibandha avidya eva and avidya is anadi vyamohaika nibandhanam the pratibandha vyamohaika nibandhanam for the wrong perception for the wrong knowledge for the wrong understanding what is the cause avidya eva avidya alone ignorance alone avidya and this avidya is anadi when did this start we cannot say but it is anadi but it is santaha avidya doesn't have adi adihi na vidyate yasyaha sa that is avidya when this avidya this ignorance started that we cannot say anadi but it is santaha it can be ended avidya is jnana virodhi therefore when jnanam comes this avidya goes away in the wake of knowledge avidya goes away when light is brought in the room which was dark for millions of years kshana matre kim bhavati the room becomes illumined even though the room was dark for millions of years how much time it will take when you just light a matchstick and illumine the room that moment itself the room is illumined so the light dispels the darkness here this jnana light this jnana this is the prakasha that dispels the avidya therefore santaha avidya anadi it is santaha you cannot say when the dream started in the dream world in the swapna when you are in the dream state swapna prapancha when was the dream started you cannot say just starts when the time you cannot say but it ends ending you know the ending when you wake up because of the dream disturbance you get up that is ended so like a dream there's avidya also anadi and it is but it can be ended there's avidya which is a pratibandha which is the cause for ajnanam which is a cause for samsara that can be ended because this is jnana virodhi you need jnanam to bring in the torchlight of jnanam and dispel this darkness of ignorance who can do that guru only can that's why guru is called ukaraha andhakara nivartakaha ukaraha ukara is darkness andhakaraha ukara tan nivartakaha that is why it's guru iti that is teaching shastam jnanam drives away the ajnanam that's avidya now the next up to this we have seen now the next shloka the 15th shloka you can read chidanandamaya brahma pratibimba samandita
चिदानंदमय
प्रकृतिर्द्विविधा च सा The first line is one word. Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita. It's a compound. It's a compound word. The line itself is a one line itself is a one word. It is an anushtup, so therefore 16 letters would be there. Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita. Tamo Rajas Sattva Gunaha Prakritihi. Sa cha dvividha. So this Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita, it is a Strilinga Shabda. You can make out in the Shabda itself. A is a Akaranta Strilinga Shabda. Like Rama Shabdavata. So Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita. Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvite. Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvitaha. So like that you can decline. So it is Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachanam. Then Tamo Rajas Sattva Gunaha. So here the last. The shloka avidya talked about that avidya is going to be described in these shlokas from the previous shloka. Avidya was introduced from the 11th to 14th shloka. Avidya was introduced, pratibandha etc. What is a pratibandha? Avidya is a pratibandha. Now this avidya is being described. So avidya is strilinga. Sattva tamo rajas sattva gunaha strilinga prakritihi is prakritihi dvividha. Prakriti is of two types. Prakriti is of two. So here sat tamo rajas sattva guna, it is not gunaha, it is tamo rajas sattva guna. You can take it is because it is strilinga qualifying it in prakriti. Prakriti is was talked about, so please correct. Tamo rajas sattva guna, it is not gunaha. I thought it is bahuvachan, therefore gunaha. No, it is guna only. It is also strilinga. Tamo rajas sattva guna prakriti dvividha chasa, because sa is everything is strilinga only, therefore it is guna only. Why it is guna? Because the first line is Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita. It is Ekavachanam. And Prakriti also Ekavachanam. Then Tamo Rajas Sattva Guna, that also has to be Ekavachanam. That also like Rama Shabda only. So it cannot be Gunaha. It cannot be Vaguvachanam. So this Tamo Rajas Sattva Guna Prakriti. The Prakriti Asti. The prakriti is tamo rajas sattva guna. For that adjective is the first line. Chidananda maya brahma pratibimba samanvita. So prakriti is chidananda maya brahma pratibimba samanvita. So both are adjectives to prakriti. What is prakriti? Ka prakriti hi, if you ask. Sa prakriti hi, what? Tamo rajas sattva guna prakriti hi. Chidananda maya brahma pratibimba samanvita prakriti. Sa prakriti dvividha cha dvividha bhavati. What is prakriti? We have seen in Tattva Bodha. Prakriti brahmashaya trigunatmika maya asti. Tattva Bodha brahmashaya. That brahmashaya is what here. The Brahmashaya, what we saw in Tattva Bodha, that is what is here. Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita. That is called Brahmashaya Maya Iti. So, Prakriti is a Moola Karanam. It is the Moola Karanam which is brings out everything. Prakritihi Kridatu Prakarshena. It has the capability to produce everything. Aghatita Ghatana Patiyasi Maya. Maya can produce that which is not possible. That which is impossible is made possible by the Maya Shakti. Prakritihi Kridatu Dukrinkarane. And Tin Prataya with Pra Upasarga Prakarshena. So it can, it has the ability to produce, to do things. That's why it's called Prakritihi. So Tin Prataya Prakritihi. So that Prakriti is the Moola Karanam. Moola Karanam Asti Prakriti. Prakritihi Moola Karanam Asti. Prakriti, does it stand alone? No, it is Brahmashaya, Maya, Brahmashaya, Prakritihi. It is along with Brahma. Srishtehe Prag, before the creation, what was there? Brahma Eva, Ekarupatvat, Sasambit, Nitya, Sasambit, it is Satyam, it is Nityam. That Brahma alone, Brahma alone, Atma alone, Brahmatma alone. Now we are talking about Prakriti. So Brahma and Prakriti are the two realities. If this it is two, like in other darshana, like Sankhya, etc. Sankhya, they talk about Prakriti and Purusha. It is Dvaita darshana, pluralistic reality, realities for them. Similarly, are there two realities for Advaiti and for us also? You say Advaiti, and how can you have two realities? Not possible. It cannot be two. Brahma is there, Maya is there. Brahma is there, Prakriti is there. How can there be Brahma and Prakriti? What is there is only Brahma. We, the Advaitins, say it is Brahma alone. It is the Paramarthika Sat. Brahma is Paramarthika Sat. It is the absolute reality. Then the other one is Pratibhasika or Vyavaharika. Vyavaharika Sat, empirical reality or subjective reality, Pratibhasika Sat. But what is Paramarthika? Without Paramarthika, how can there be Vyavaharika Sat? How can there be Pratibhasika Sat? Without Brahma, without this absolute reality, Brahma, how can there be empirical or subjective reality? Not possible. Because for everything, that astitvam, it is given by what? It is by Brahma alone. That is Paramarthika Sat. So therefore, Brahma Paramarthika Rupena Asti. And Prakriti is Na Paramarthika. It is Aparamarthika. Paramarthika Rupena Asti. It is not, doesn't have Paramarthika Satta. Paramarthika Satyam. In the Paramarthika Satyam, there cannot be division. So, therefore, what is there is only Brahma. Because we say Prakriti doesn't mean it is two. It is one whole alone. Brahma alone. There is no two. And when we say two, the two is not real. Prakriti is cannot, it is not real. That one ekam Brahma, in that there cannot be varieties and there cannot be divisions. So Paramarthika Sat Brahma ekam, this Vyavaharika Sat or Pratibhasika Sat, therefore it is not real, it is Namarupatmakam iti. Therefore this Prakriti, which is made of this, the Triguna, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas, it is presented in a threefold manner. Prakriti consists of three gunas. Therefore, this Prakriti is presented in threefold. There can be division because it is not Paramarthika. Aparamarthika. Aparamarthike. Aparamarthika Vishaye. This Vedaha possible. The divisions are possible, but in divisions are not possible in the paramarthika dharma. Therefore, prakriti only has the division of this tama, rajas, and sattva. This division is only in the prakriti, only in the maya, not in the brahma, not in the shuddha brahma. Shuddha brahma parat paradam. So doesn't have this division. And therefore, this prakriti, having these three gunas, tamo guna, rajo guna, sattva guna. Therefore, this three gunatmaka, trigunatmika prakriti, trigunatmika maya, that prakriti, each guna has got some characteristics. Sattva, rajas, and tamas. Each guna has got some characteristics. What is rajas? Kriyatmika vikshepa shakti rajasaha. In Viveka Chudamani, Bhashyakara, Shankaracharya beautifully says what is rajoguna, or he explains nicely. Vikshepa shakti rajasakriyatmika yatah pravrtif prasrita purani ragadayo syav prabhavanti nityam dukkhadayo ye manaso vikarah. That is rajas. It is vikshepa shakti rajasaha kriyatmika vikshepa shakti rajasaha. This rajas, this rajoguna, when a person has rajoguna, he is active. Rajoguna stands for this kriyatmika. It stands for the active. One is active, one is dynamic. And also raga dayaha asyaha prabhavanti nityam. There will be raga dayaha, attachment, and all the other. The agitations of the mind will be thus. Raga is there, therefore shoka, dukkha, everything will be there. Dukkha dayaha ye manasaha vikaraha. That is rajoguna. And kama krodha, etc. That also kama krodha, lobha, moha, damba, asuya, ahankara, irsya, all this. All this rajoguna manifesting in the person in the form of this. That is rajoguna. Rajoguna stands for activity. When activity is there, all these things are possible. All these things will be there. Sattva. Sattva has the capacity of reflecting consciousness in it because of its nature. Sattva guna. Sattva guna, it is Vishuddham. Jalavat. In Vivekacharya Ramani, it is said Jalavat. Like, yeah, the pure water, Jalavat. It manifests reflects the Shuddha Chaitanyam. It is able to reflect Brahma Chaitanyam. Whereas Rajas and Tamas, they don't have the capacity to reflect the Brahma Chaitanyam. All the objects of the world, and including the beings, human beings, any being, are made of this Triguna. In the Jada Vastu, these three gunas are there. Among them also, there is a gradation of the manifestation of these three gunas. And in a human being also, this guna manifests in different gradations. Every being, every human being, or every being has these three gunas. These three gunas are required for the stability of a human being. So in the human being, if rajoguna manifests, activity, manifests in the form of action, manifests in the form of kama, krodha, raga, deha, etc. All those things are possible. And tamas stands for darkness. Darkness means inertia, inactivity, laziness. That manifests when you sleep. In sleep, there is no action, only ignorance, tamas. And there are objects which are tamas. They are very solid. They are jada, which cannot reflect the Brahma Chaitanyam. There is a gradation in the objects. The water can reflect, sun, whereas a stone cannot reflect sun. So that mirror can reflect the sunlight more better than the water. And water can do better than the stone. So there is a gradation. So all the vastu, all the beings are made of this three guna. So sattva guna among them, sattva guna has the capacity to reflect this brahma chaitanyam consciousness. So therefore only sattvat jnanam sanjayate. We say knowledge is possible because of this sattva guna. Therefore, one has to increase this sattva guna. If it is sattva guna pradhanaha, purushaha, that person is called brahmanaha, not because of jati, not because of karma. Sattva guna pradhanaha, purushaha is brahmanaha. Because sattva guna is there, therefore, the person is available for knowing, for understanding. So, therefore, the unique characteristic of this guna, sattva guna, is knowledge. And rajas is action. And tamoguna is there is neither knowledge nor action. It is, both are not there. And we can see these guna manifesting in sleep. In sleep, why we say in sleep? Because in sleep there is no karta, there is no pramata. So that because there is no pramata, there is absence of knowledge. There is no karta, therefore there is no action. So knowledge stands for sattva. Sattva, where when knowledge takes place, then sattva guna is, if sattva guna is there, we can infer. When the person is karta, it means he is, yes, then it is rajas. It is rajas, manifestation of rajas. When both are not there, when there is no karta, when there is no pramata, then it is tamas. So we can see the manifestation of these three gunas in a person also. When the person is a knower, then it is manifestation of sattva guna. When the person is a doer, karta, then it is a manifestation of this rajoguna. When neither of them, then it is tamas. As it manifests in the same person at different times in the day, similarly, the whole jagat is made of these three gunas. And that is what is prakriti is. These three gunas are in prakriti. If these three gunas, according to Sankhya, they say, Sankhya Darshana, because Vedanta has borrowed many ideas from Sankhya. Even in the 7th chapter of the Gita, Bhagavan Krishna, he presents the Sankhya, Darshana ideas. The creation and all, the idea has been taken from Sankhya. Vedanta doesn't have problem, it can take from any, but ultimately it will dismiss as Mithya. So therefore, Vedanta is not interested in establishing the Srishti. Not interested in establishing the creation because it is mithya, whether it is there or not. It is mithya. Namarupatmaka jagat, it is mithya. Satyas, Paramatika Satyas, only Brahma. So if it is mithya, mithya can be talked about by any darshana. Therefore, no problem. Therefore, we can accept the concept of creation from any darshana because it is going to be dismissed as mithya. Therefore, but the Sankhya presents beautifully the idea of the creation. Therefore, Vedanta Darshana also takes that idea from Sankhya Darshana. So according to Sankhya, there are two things, Prakriti and Purusha. And about Prakriti, they say, they are three of three gunas, Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, Iti. When they are in equal proportion, no one will be able to express itself. None of the guna will be able to express itself. There will not be action, there will not be knowledge, there will not be neither of them. So, that none of them would be able to express itself. Because each one, what does it do? It weighs down the other. So, therefore, Samya Avastha of Prakriti, in the Samya Avastha of Prakriti, that is in the stable situation, the equilibrium, in the state of equilibrium, there is neither action, there is neither knowledge, nor tamas. That is the original condition or nature of Prakriti, Trigunatmika Prakriti. And this Prakriti is because of Brahma. Brahma blesses the Prakriti. Prakriti is lighted up. Prakriti gets existence because of Brahma all the time. Therefore, but Brahma is Ananta, it is infinite, and that Ananta Brahma Chaitanyam, because it is Ananta, Therefore, it blesses even the Prakriti also. It cannot reduce its blessing. It blesses this Prakriti. And therefore, this Prakriti is Brahma Chaitanya, Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita. It is associated with Pratibimba, Samyak Anvita, Samanvita. Samyak Anvita, Brahma Pratibimba and Samanvita. Satchidananda Brahma Chaitanyam, it is reflected in this Prakriti. It means the Prakriti manifests this Brahma Chaitanyam, or Prakriti gets existence because of this Brahma Chaitanyam. Therefore, this Prakriti is Brahma Pratibimba, not the Bimba. That's why it is reflected consciousness, we say. It means the consciousness must be there as Brahma original, and that is reflected in the Prakriti. So this reflected, because of this Prakriti only, because of this reflected Chaitanyam only, the reflected Chaitanyam, that proves the existence of Brahma Chaitanyam. The person is there, the person, the Chaitanya manifest. This Shariram is Jadam. Indriyas are also Jadam. The mind is there, Indriyas will not function. So mind is there, therefore Indriyas function. But mind is also Jadam only. It is also Jadam only. But the mind thinks, the mind, all the vrittis happen, thoughts come and go. Because the mind thinks, it doesn't mean that mind is Chaitanya. Mind is enjoys, or in the mind, Chaitanyam is, because of Chaitanyam, the mind thinks the antakaranam does the job of this thinking, decision making. All the activities are performed by the antakaranam in the presence of Chaitanyam, minus Brahma Chaitanyam. Antakaranam also being Jada, it cannot do. Like in the presence of the light, like in the presence of the reflected light, the objects in the room are illumined. Similarly, that mind being a subtle medium, in that the Brahma Chaitanyam is reflected. Because it is reflected, therefore it is able to illumine all the jada vrittis. All the vrittis come and go. They are all illumined by the reflected Chaitanyam. So what the antakarnam does, it only reflects the Chaitanyam. And because of that only, all the thinking, all the other decision making, all the other activities are possible. Antakarnam itself cannot do. If antakarnam itself can do, then antakarnam becomes a reality. Antakarnam is Jadam. Therefore, this Brahma Chaitanyam, which is obtained in the Antakarnam, that is called Chidabhasa, that is called Pratibimba. Therefore, Pratibimba Samanvita. This reflection is Brahma Pratibimbaha. It is Chidananda Mayaha. Chit Ananda Mayaha. This reflected consciousness of the Antakarnam, it is Chit Abhasa. It is reflection of Chit Brahma, Brahma Chaitanyam. Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita Ka, this Sattva Rajas Tamo Gunatmika Prakriti. And for that only, this, I give the example, this Antakarnam. Antakarnam is made of this, it's nothing but Prakriti, made of these three gunas, and it is reflects the Brahma Pratibimba, because it is, even though it is a Jada, among the Jada, there are gradations of reflection. Mind is being made of Sattvaguna, it has the ability to manifest this Chaitanya. Reflection means manifest. We have a model called Pratibimba Vada. That is why we use the word reflection. If reflection word is it's, if it is confusing, then we can use the word manifest. This Antakarnam manifests the Brahma Chaitanyam. Therefore, it is Chidananda Maya. Maya. Maya is a Pratyaya. Mayat Pratyaya. Mayat Pratyaya. It's a Pratyaya. So this Mayat Pratyaya, which is added to the Pratipadigam in Subanta, the word in two ways, in two senses. Mayat Pratyaya. One is in the sense of modification. Vikararte Mayat Pratyaya Bhavati. Example, Annamaya, when you say. What is Annamaya? Annamaya means it is full of annam. What is full of annam? The body is Annamaya. When we say Shariram is Annamaya, it means the Shariram, the body is full of annam. Annam means food. It is not food. It is the modification of the food. The body is nothing but the modification of food. It is not just made of idli, sambar, etc., the body. It is modified into, the annam is modified into this Shariram. Therefore, Annamaya Shariram. So, Vikararte Mayat Pratyaha Bhavati. That is one sense this Mayat Pratyaya is added. Annasya Vikaraha, Anna Vikaraha, Annamaya Shariram Iti. The other meaning is Prachuryarte. Prachuryarte. Prachurya means abundance, plenty. Suppose the place is heavily rained and water is everywhere. Everywhere there is water. Then what do you say? Or if you go to this Ganga Sagar, everywhere is water. You can't see the merging of the Ganga with the ocean. The other side of the shore can't be seen. It's like a ocean. You say Jalamayam. You say Jalamayam. What is that? That Maya is? It is not Vikarat. It is not a modification of water. It is Jalamaya means everywhere is Jalam, abundance, plenty of water. So, that is second meaning, Jalamaya. Can we take the meaning here? Chidanandamaya. Which meaning we can take? Vikarate or Prachuryate? If you take Vikarate, Chidanandamaya, it is Vikara of the Chidananda. Vikara, the change of the Chit. How can Brahma undergo change to become this? If Brahma is changeable, Brahma is mutable, then it is not Brahma. That which can change cannot be Brahma. Brahma is avyayam, avyaktoyam, achintyoyam, avikaryoyam, uchyate. If Brahma also changes, then everything is changing, the changing becomes satyam. Brahma is, it is anadi, it is ananta, doesn't undergo any change. If it undergoes change, then Brahma will have form. If it has a form, then it will have parts, avayava. If it has parts, then it can do kriya. If it can do kriya, then it's subject to all the modification. Then Brahma also is born, asti, jayate, vardate, viparinamate, apakshyate, vinashyate, all these things are possible. So therefore, Brahma will also will have a birth and it also will have a death. Date of time, arrival, date of departure will be there for Brahma if it is mayat in the sense of vikararte. So that cannot be the meaning. Can we take prachuryarte? It is plenty of chit. That also we cannot say. What is plenty of chit? That is also plenty is also quantifiable. When you say plenty, abundance, that is also quantifiable only. So that meaning also we cannot take. What is, how much quantifiable? It is 100 tons or 1,000 tons or 1 million tons of Brahma. That is also not, that is also, it's finite only. So therefore, that also we cannot take. These are the two senses in which Maya Pratyaya is mostly added to the noun. Even these two things are dismissed, cannot be. Then what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning this Pratyaya gives when it is added to the noun? Maya Pratyaya here, it is added in the sense of Swarupa. Rarely we see the Maya Pratyaya added in this meaning. Only in Vedanta you will see Swaruparte Mayat. So Vikararte Mayat, Prachuryarte Mayat, Swaruparte Mayat, in the sense of, in this sense of Swarupam, Swaruparte. So Chidananda, Chidananda is not Vikara, Chidananda is not Prachurya. So Chidananda Maya is, it is Swaruparte, that Brahma, Chidananda Maya, Brahma, Tasya, Brahmanaha, Swarupam is Chitta, Chitta, Anandaha. It is Chitta, Chaitanyam, Ananda, Anantaha, Ananta Chitta, that which doesn't have limitation, that which does unlimited consciousness. That is the Swarupa of Brahma. So Chidananda Maya is Brahma. Chidananda Maya is Brahma, which is Chidananda Maya. Brahma, which is of the nature of unlimited consciousness. That is what Brahma is. Brahma is Chit Ananda Maya, Chidananda Maya. Sat Chit Ananda. Sat means Sat also you can bring in. Sat Chit Ananda Maya Brahma. Tasya Brahmanaha Pratibimba Samanvita Ka, this Prakriti. Therefore, this Chidananda Maya Brahma Pratibimba Samanvita. Samyak Anvita, well associated with the reflection of this Brahma, which is of the nature of Chit and Ananda, unlimited consciousness. What is Samanvita? What associates with Brahma? This Prakritihi, Sa Prakritihi, Chidananda Maya, Brahma, Pratibimba, Samanvita, Sa Prakritihi. Chit cha idam anandamayam. Chidanandamayam iti chit cha idam anandamayam. Chidanandamayam. That is Karmadare Samasa. Chidanandamaya Brahma. Chidanandamayam cha tat Brahma. That is also Karmadaraya. Chidanandamaya Brahma. So Karmadaraya Garba, Karmadaraya Samasa. That part. Now, Chidanandamaya Brahmanaha Prati. Bimbaha, Chidananda Maya Brahma Prati Bimbaha, that is Shashti Tatpurusha. Now, Tena Samanvita, Prati Bimbena Samanvita, Chidananda Maya Brahma Prati Bimbena Samanvita, Chidananda Maya Brahma Prati Bimba Samanvita, it's a beautiful word. So finally it is Tritiya Tatpurusha, so long one. Tritiya Tatpurusha, then Shashti, then Karmadarya, then Karmadarya. So many Samasa, so the words are there. Good example for our Samasa class. Chit cha idam anandamayam, chidanandamayam. Chidanandamayam cha tat brahma, chidanandamaya brahma. Chidanandamaya brahmanaha pratibimbaha, chidanandamaya brahma pratibimbaha. Chidanandamaya brahma pratibimbhena, samyak anvita ka prakriti. Chidanandamaya brahma pratibimba samanvita prakriti. That one word only we explained so far. Now that prakriti is of two types, Dvividha Bhavati. Even though the author here, he says it's of two types, Dvividha. But it is of three types. Why he said Dvividha? Why it can be Trividha? Three types. Three gunas are there, therefore three types. Sattva Pradhana Prakriti, Tamas Pradhana Prakriti, Rajas Pradhana Prakriti. So three types possible, but author says two types because he is going to present Sattva Pradhana Prakriti and Rajas Pradhana Prakriti. Tamas Pradhana Prakriti, that he would say later. So he will talk about only two types of the Prakriti. Sattva Pradhana Prakriti and Rajas Pradhana Prakriti. So all the three gunas are mixed up and they are in the state of equilibrium. When it is disturbed, then there is a manifestation of this guna. When it is disturbed, then these gunas manifest. In some, the sattva guna is dominant. In some, rajas is dominant. When sattva is dominant, then it is called sattva pradhana. When rajas is dominant, it is called rajas pradhana. When tamas dominates, then becomes tamas pradhana prakriti. When tamas is the pradhana, then other two will be secondary. When rajas is pradhana, then the other two will be secondary. When rajas, and similarly when sattva is pradhana, the other two will be secondary. We will discuss on this in terms of this Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, Chaturvarnya, Maya, Srishtam, Gunakarma, Vivahyo. In that shloka, Gita shloka, we will discuss beautifully. It is presented how it is classified into four divisions: Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. In Brahmana, Sattvaguna is Pradhana. What about Rajas? Rajas also. Rajas comes second and only Tamas. So Sattva followed by Rajas followed by Tamas. Whereas in Kshatriya, Rajas is dominant and that is supported by Sattva. That is that below that Tasva, that is that below that Rajas only, sorry, Sattva only, Tamas. That is, Tamas is secondary to Sattva. Sattva is secondary to Rajas in the case of Kshatriya. So similarly in other two Varnas. So it is nothing but the manifestation of this Guna. So, and here, with regard to the Prakriti, the Srishti, when we talk about, there also there is a gradation. Sattva Pradhana Prakriti, Rajas Pradhana Prakriti. So therefore, the Prakriti is divided into here, Dvividha Bhavati, iti, Sa Prakriti Dvividha. Prakriti is Srilinga, therefore, Sa Prakriti Dvividha Bhavati. So, now, this Brahma, Brahma Chaitanyam, it is Sarva Vyapi, all pervasive. Then Prakriti also is, the Prakriti also is all pervasive. Brahma Pratibhamba is, therefore Brahma Pratibhamba is also limitless. If it is limitless, then Prakriti is limitless, then Brahma Chaitanyam also will be Ananta. So when, where Brahma Pratibhambam is, there Brahma is. Reflected consciousness is, if it is all pervasive, as it is reflected in Prakriti, that means Brahma is also all pervasive. So, if Prakriti is all pervasive, then Brahma is all pervasive. Because you see Prakriti only, the whole universe, the cosmos, everything is the Prakriti. Therefore, can you quantify the space? What space is cannot be quantified? Everything is contained in the space, and space itself, what space? That cannot be said. It is so vast, infinite. If that is Prakriti, if Prakriti is infinite, what about Brahma Chaitanya? It is, has to be limitless. So if Prakriti is limitless, the Brahma is also limitless, because Prakriti is because of Brahma. Prakriti, the Prakriti only, this, there is manifestation of this Brahma. So therefore, where there is Pratibhimba, there Brahma is. So therefore, both Brahma and Brahma Pratibhimba are there. The Pratibhimba is because of, the Pratibhimba in the Prakriti is because of Brahma. So therefore, it is, the Prakriti is called Chit, Pratibhimba of Prakriti. The Pratibhimba, the reflection of Brahma in the Prakriti is called Chit Abhasa, Chidabhasa, reflected consciousness. This Brahma Chaitanyam reflected in Sattva Guna, this Antakaranam made of Sattva Guna, therefore Sattva Guna is called Chidabhasa. It is called Chit Abhasa, translated as reflected consciousness, manifested consciousness, Chit Abhasa, Chidabhasa. In Sattva Guna alone, this reflection takes place. So, therefore, the Moolakaranam is Prakriti. Moolakaranam of this samsara. Samsara means this Srishti, this Jagat is Prakriti. It has three gunas. Sattva, Rajas, Tamo, Guna, Gunatmika, Prakriti. When they are not in equal proportion, when the proportions are disturbed, then Prakriti, Srishti starts. So at that time, that Prakriti is looked upon as Sattva Pradhana Prakriti, Rajas Pradhana Prakriti, Tamas Pradhana Iti. Sattva stands for knowledge and Tamas for action, Rajas for action and Tamas for inertia. So these three types of the Prakriti. So when it is disturbed, then Srishti starts. Srishti starts, and in the Srishti, there will be the manifestation of these three gunas. So based on that, we say it is सत्व प्रधान तम प्रधान रजस प्रधान इति दट इज दि मीनिंग ऑफ दिस श्लोक दट प्रकृति इज नाउ बेस्ड ऑन वॉट डॉमिनेट्स वॉट गुना डॉमिनेट्स इट इज गोइंग टू गेट द नेम दट प्रकृति इज ऑफ इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड बाय द नेम माया is also called by the name avidya. With regard to the total, it is called maya. That is, with regard to ishvara, it is called maya. With regard to individual, it is called avidya. For ishvara, the maya is a vibhuti. Maya is under the control of ishvara. Maya is under the control of ishvara. It is vibhuti of ishvara. Whereas avidya, under avidya, only this human being is under the control of this avidya. So avidya controls, or a person is under the influence of avidya, whereas Ishvara cannot be influenced by maya. Maya to prakritim vidyam, mayinam to maheshwaram. So mayina is Ishvara, maya is prakriti. So prakriti obeys, or prakriti is under Ishvara, whereas we are under avidya means we are influenced by avidya, whereas Ishvara cannot be influenced by maya. That's why maya is the vibhuti of Ishvara. It is the glory of Ishvara. This jagat, which is the manifestation of this Brahma Ishvara, is its glory, the manifestation because of this prakriti. Therefore the prakriti is the glory. All the gunas are the glory of Bhagavan, whereas for a ajnani jiva, this prakriti in the form of avidya, with regard to the vishti, it is called avidya. Under avidya only, when it comes under the influence of avidya only, human beings suffer. That is called samsara. So jiva has got samsara, Ishvara doesn't have samsara. Maya doesn't put Ishvara under samsara, whereas avidya can put a jiva under samsara. It has got that power. It has got that shakti, maya shakti. It's called avidya, ajnanam iti. So based on what dominates the prakriti, sattva, pradhana prakriti, and rajas pradhana prakriti, the author is going to present further. We will see that in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांतिः. हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरिः ओम.
धन्यवाद
गुरुजी.
धन्यवाद
गुरुजी.
धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद.